Nicknamed the King Fish, Huey Pierce Long was born on August 30, 1893, in Winfield, Louisiana. The Longs were far from rich, but were well off compared to their surrounding community. Huey's parents, Huey Sr. and Caledonia, made a living as livestock farmers. The Longs rarely had much trouble making ends meet, but plenty of the people around them did, which was a major influence on a young Huey. One story recounts is how, as an 8-year-old boy, he watched his neighbor lose his house and farm at an auction when the neighbor failed to pay his debt on time. The farmer begged to be given his home back, swearing he'd pay his debt if he just had been given a few more days to get the money together. Just as the sheriff was about to stop the auction and grant the neighbor's request, a creditor made a bid, winning the farm immediately. As an adult, Huey Long recalled the event, remarking that he was horrified. Quote, "I could not understand. It seemed criminal." Huey Long would go on to serve as the 40th governor of Louisiana from 1928 to 1932, and U.S. Senator from 1932 to 1935. In February 1934, Huey Long started to advocate for many government reforms and programs to stop the spread of communism in America. Among these programs was his famous Share Our Wealth program. Long introduced his Share Our Wealth plan over a nationwide radio broadcast, stating, "We do not propose to divide the wealth up equally. We do not propose a division of wealth, but we do propose to limit poverty that we will allow to be inflicted upon any man's family. We will not say that we are going to try and guarantee any equality, or $15,000 to a family. No. But we do say that 1/3 of the average is low enough for any one family to hold. That there should be a guarantee of a family wealth of around $5,000, enough for a home, an automobile, a radio, the ordinary conveniences, and the opportunity to educate their children." He proposed capping personal fortunes at $50 million and made a call to limit annual income to $1 million. The resulting funds would be used to guarantee every family a basic household grant of $5,000 and a minimum annual income of $2,000 to $3,000, or 1/3 of the average family.
"We start from the bottom, that the 25 or more million American families shall have a homestead, a home, and the comforts of a home, including an automobile and a radio, the things it takes in that house to live on. We say to America, 125 million, none shall be too big, none shall be too poor."
Despite what some of Huey Long's opponents would say, Long was never really interested in some type of socialist utopia. What he was interested in, however, was preventing poverty, so he would never have to witness the suffering of people the way that he did as a boy in Winfield. Huey was also staunchly religious, and often referred to his Share Our Wealth program to be in accordance with God's law. Quote, "And thus today, America ignores God's law. It allows all wealth and income to be in the hands of few, and the millions starve in the midst of plenty." Huey often made critiques on socialism. Long's program was diverged significantly from the socialist policy. In particular, the Share Our Wealth program preserved the concept of private property and also sought to avoid the need for any violent revolution. When asked whether his party was communist, Long replied, "Communism? Hell no. This plan is the only defense this country's got against communism." Long also called the program the only stopgap to communism. Long believed that socialism and fascism was on the rise in America due to the Great Depression and the government's inability to respond to it properly. He seen this Share Our Wealth program as the only thing that could mediate the issues at hand, and called FDR a communist on many occasions, quoting, "Hold the Democratic Convention and Communist Convention together to save money." Although his opponents labeled Long as a communist, legitimate American communists sought to distance themselves from Long and his Share the Wealth program. They believed his policies both preserved the capitalist enterprise and diverted interest away from their own party. Some of Long's fiercest critics were prominent American communists, such as Sender Garland and Alexander Bittelman. They argue that Long's populist rhetoric and antics belied a decidedly anti-labor philosophy. Garland, for instance, noted that while Long constructed thousands of miles of roads and numerous bridges, the state paid its workers only 30 cents an hour, 10 cents less than what the National Recovery Administration called during the Great Depression. Now we are going to highlight why Long's share of wealth program is as America first as it's going to get. Long understood that communists and socialists alike would use the deteriorating status of America's economy to try and seize some sort of power. He knew that they would try to use the lack of jobs, poverty, and inflation as a critique of the American government and attempt to sway these desperate Americans into their corrupted way of thinking and try to make America similar to the oppressive system in the Soviet Union. The program was centered around the idea that families should be able to live comfortably, with all the basic necessities that a family would need. Additionally, it is to be noted that the plan only does apply to families, and not just anyone, which would create an incentive to have a family, which in today's age would help the birth rates, which have seemed to be decreasing more and more. The Share Our Wealth program does not only incentivize creation of strong families, it also allows them to be created. In modern day, the average cost of raising a child born to a middle-income married couple is more than $14,800 a year per child. So consider the average household income in the United States is about $67,521. That would mean that the average American household would spend 65.76% of their income on just three children, and they would still need to cover expenses for gas and other necessities. Just three children is already a lot in modern standards, but is nothing compared to the average four children, which were steadily provided for by a singular breadwinner, the father, in the 1950s. In short, the Share Our Wealth program will stand as a bulwark against the spread of communism, create a better living environment for all Americans to thrive in, create the ability to have a large, healthy, and well-provided-for family, which have been dropping in numbers in the last 50 years. The Share Our Wealth program puts Americans first in more ways than just the political sense. It puts Americans first where it matters, the home and the family. The program would make American families great again, and provide for all families where no man is too poor, at least kept in check, and truly make every man a king. Thank you for checking out this video. If you liked it, please make sure to like and subscribe. If you want to see more videos, leave comments or suggestions, and I'll be sure to check them out. See you next time. And remember, in our America, every man is a king.